guys, so I want to share this solution with you. So if you are having trouble connecting your SSH to your computer from Siteground, then this might work, and it works for me. I was really having trouble in it, so I managed to figure this out. So yeah, if you are using Siteground, so I'm trying to use SSH because I want to use Sage for my WordPress themes. So yeah, so in order to do that, you need to go to the cPanel, and okay, cPanel, and I have a website that is schools.bookroomhead.com. So my plan is actually, I think I have a problem with cache, but basically this is the site. So I want to use Sage and I want to use SSH to expedite my process. So yeah, in order to do that, by the way, I'm using a old version of cPanel. Siteground doesn't updated my cPanel yet, but the process should be the same. So you need to go to SSH, okay, the shell access, and then you need to create your key. Okay, I'm gonna remove this key later, because I'm gonna providing since I'll be showing you all the data. So let's go this and G, and actually, okay, it's actually Bookroom Head and hi at Bookroom Head .com and password. Password, and then you need to put your IP address. If you want to just use your, you just want to limit the access on your own computer. So basically here, go to the whatismyip.org. So what is my IP, or what is my IP address.com. I'm using that one. They just both the same. And just grab that IP and put it here, and then generate. Okay, now go back to the once it's already generated, it will appear here. This is the one that we have. Okay, before we dive in with loading our private key, make sure that you have a PuTTY. So you need to have a PuTTY. I'm not so sure how to pronounce that, but yeah, you need to have PuTTY, and you also need to have install a PuTTY, and you also need to install a PuTTY generator. Okay, so yeah, so do that. If you already have that, then we are good to go. Now okay, first is we will go to the PuTTY, and then not PuTTY, it's PuTTY generator, PuttyGen, and then we will install this private key. So we'll install that we will download that private key. So get the private key there, and then put it in the notepad, and then save it. Let's try, I'm gonna put that into different folder, call that PTK, and we'll call that private PuTTY, and then we will make sure that it's on files and use PPK as an extension, and then go to the PuTTY generator and then load that private PuTTY. Now we will load that private PuTTY and click that PPK folder and load the file that we did, and then enter the password. So this is the password that you just created earlier. Remember when you go here with SSH and then shell access. Remember when you created your first name, last name, email address, and a password? That's the password that you're gonna put there. So I'll put my password, and then it says that it's ready successfully imported, so we're good in that. Now once it's already imported, we need to save again the private key. Now click this save private key, and then let's call that Putty, that PPK. Okay, now we already have that folder, we already have the other generated of Putty, which is the Putty.ppk. Now we need to go to the right click and then load into pageant, whatever it is called. But yeah, just load it in the pageant, then again put your password and okay. Now if you check this one, you'll see that this key is already loaded to the pageant. Now it's time to go to the Putty. Okay, why it's popping, but oh, it's my computation. So go to the Putty generator, PuttyGen, and then not PuttyGen, I'm so sorry for confusing you, it should be Putty. Okay, you need to go to the Putty and put in your host name. I'm gonna put my host name here. So this one, you can see it in this area. You can use just your host name, and you can also use your IP address. Okay, why SSH is important? SSH is super helpful for you to expedite your WordPress development, because it's just easy. Let's say if you use File Manager or File FTP, it will take time to upload those files, and with SSH it's faster. So just put the host name or your IP address, and make sure the port is always 17658. And yeah, 17658, it is uniform. Use that if you are using a SSH and you are using Putty as your connector. So 17658, and then open. Okay, it will generate something like this, and you will be... Okay, I forgot to load the Putty, but it shouldn't be like that. Hold on. It should be Putty, and I'm going to put my host name here, and 17658. Actually, I'm doing it right earlier, so again, open. So it might take a bit long to load, but why? It should be loading faster. What's wrong? There is a server timeout. Okay, I will if that happens, you just need to refresh your Putty. But yeah, so what we will do again is I'm going to exit that and right click and load the pageant again, and then my password, and then go to the Putty and then put the username, username, and then it's 1718. My port is not right, so 18765, and then make sure it is SSH, and then open. Interesting. Okay, I have I forgot to put the S is not right, so you want to make sure that your host name is typed in correctly, otherwise you will get a connection error. So 187.685 port is 187.685, then open. Now you will be asked for login details. So you'll be asked for your username. I use my email address and I was so frustrated because it doesn't work, and I spent almost 1 hour troubleshooting the problem, but then I just realized that I use my email address connecting to the ACES to the Siteground server. So you need to make sure that it is okay. You need to make sure that it is, let's put it again. So you need to make sure that it's not an email address, but it is your username. So 18768, and then open. Cannot assign request network server. Why? Let me try to use my IP address. Putty. 1768. Not load, open instead. Okay, so it is authenticating. Do not use your email address as your login, otherwise this will not work. You will have problem with connection error. So we're already in the server. So if I go to ls, you will see all the files that it installed. And then when I go to the like www, which is the main thing, so cd www, and then let's ls, you'll see all the subdomains that I've installed in the shared host. So I'm gonna look for the subdomain that I created, which is the school here. So cd and then school, and yeah, go to the cd and then w, I think it's cd wp content, right? And then cd theme. Okay, so I'm gonna install the Sage here. So I'm going to use Sage for my WordPress themes. If you want, and this will be the separate video for this thing. And yeah, I'll let you know. I'm going to give you an update on that. And I hope this helped. If you're having trouble with your Putty, let me know. Comment down below. I'll be happy to help you out. Have a great day. And again, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell notification if you want to learn more and see videos from Bookworm Head. And yeah, have a great day.